Welcome back to Early Access titled Theme Park Studio. This is video number 3 in the Build With Me series. Today we'll look at particles and lighting effects to enhance your rides, the landscape, the buildings, and your overall park. As always, we'll go slow enough so that those who would like to follow along may do so. Let's go ahead and get started by going to a new park. Okay, so we're on a new park and I'm somewhere in the middle of a tile and I have the snap tool turned on, set to 1 foot. Now before I start adding particles and lighting, it would be good to have some objects in the scene for those to interact with. So I'm going to start by quickly adding a steel looper coaster. And I'm going to add a station. Once the coaster has been added with the coaster house, go ahead and from the specialty segments box, select Lift 100 and click Build. We'll then want to follow that up with the second from the left hand most drop and select Build 3 times. And then select the flat piece and click Build 15 to 20 times. So you should end up with a coaster that looks like this. Now we'll move out to the middle of the flat area and we'll select a random node, turn back on the coaster editor, and select tunnel. Do that for the next node as well, so you should have a 2-node tunnel. The last thing we want to do to the coaster is move out a couple nodes in front of the tunnel. Select a node, hold down shift, and drag it close to the ground. Do that for the next 4 or 5 nodes. Now we want to add a path that runs parallel to the coaster, so I'm going to select the path tool and basic path, and I want the path to point back to the coaster house, and go ahead and build it all the way back. Don't have to worry about being exact, you just want a path that runs parallel. So now, a quick tip I wanted to mention from Troy on YouTube is that if you hold down the Control and Alt key, you can actually select random nodes on your path. That's in addition to drawing a box around all nodes. Control Alt will select the nodes that you click on. And I want to go to the auto-generated objects and turn on street lamps. Then I want to add a sidewalk to this, so I go back to path properties, turn on sidewalk, and now I want to line my street lamps up with the actual path. Okay, and through the magic of the internet, you can see I've retextured my path. Feel free to retexture yours however you like it. And we should have a park with a coaster and some buildings. So now let's look at particles and lighting. To do this, we're going to turn on the night environment. I'm going to click the environment button and go to night partly cloudy. And you can see my path comes alive with the lights. Okay, so the next step is to actually change the color of the lights on the path. And the way that we do that is to open up the light button and click the properties. Here you can see you have a light color that you can change. And it'll ask you, do you want to change all lights to the similar channel? Choose yes. Now, what you'll notice sometimes is that the lights don't actually change, and that's because these were auto-generated. If your lights did not change, here's the way that you can fix this. Close the light button box, go back to Path Tools, and click on Path Object Library. Scroll down until you see the street lamp, and go ahead and place the street lamp somewhere in your scene. Make sure that the street lamp is selected, and go back to Lights and Properties. Now you should be able to change the color of all lights on the path. The attenuation is how bright the light is, so if I change it from 40 to 80, you'll notice the lights will get brighter. If I change it down to 20, obviously they get dimmer. I'm going to go ahead and leave mine set to 40, and I'm going to select this light green color. Now, one thing about light colors, you can select other and choose from the standard color palette, or you could create your own custom colors. Now I'm going to delete the light that I put out here on the path. And let's move on to placing some lights underneath these cafe columns. So we're going to go ahead and open up the lights button again if you don't already have it open. And we're going to select the blue Omni Fast Render light. And we're going to place it in the front columns underneath the first and the third column. Now, if your snap tool won't allow you to place directly underneath the column, go ahead and turn snap off. And again, place it under the first and last column. In the middle column, go ahead and place a purple light. I have to press escape to turn this off. Select the purple light and place it under this column. Press escape. And then let's place three white lights under the columns behind the first row of columns. So now I want to change the color of the white lights. I'm going to go ahead and select one of the white lights and go to Properties and set the color to red. And you notice that the color now changes to red. I'm going to do the same for the blue lights and change them to a dark blue color. Well, they're already dark blue, but I'm going to raise the attenuation to make them brighter. And that's still not blue enough, so let's see what we can do to make those a little bit more blue. There we go. I had a dark blue color selected instead of the bright blue. So now that gives my cafe some nice color. And if I wanted to, I could place some bushes underneath these columns to go ahead and hide those lights. And let's move on to placing some particles. So let's come over to in front of the cafe where we have the planter boxes, and let's open up the particles button. And you can see that the particles have two buttons, number one and number two. Particles under button 1 can be placed directly on the ground. They don't require that they attach to an object. Particles under number 2 do require that they attach to an object, so you could not place these directly on the ground. In this instance, we're going to place a fountain in the middle planter next to the middle column. So we want particles under number 2, and we're going to select the fountain from the list. And you notice your cursor turns into the rainbow cursor. Go ahead and click on the back of the planter right in front of the middle column, and it places a particle there. Press escape key to turn that off. And then we're going to go ahead and open up the Particles Editor or Properties box. And there's a couple different ways that you can select this particle. One is to click on the actual particle box, which turns it red. Or you could select it from the drop-down list. Now I have more particles than you will probably because I've been playing with them while not recording. The trigger controls how the particle interacts with the environment or with you. So on camera proximity, it determines how close the camera proximity is to the particle and turns it on and off. With train proximity, it does that for the coaster. So if I change it to train proximity and set it to 100, anytime the coaster comes within 100, that particle will turn on. Now, using multiple particles in a park, it may be a good idea to change them to camera proximity or train proximity so they're not always running. In this case, I'm not going to change this property. The emitters you can actually read about under Help, Documentation, and Particle Effects. We're going to go ahead and change some properties here under the distribution. Let's change the strength up to 3000 and watch the impact that has on our particles. You can see that they're now emitting stronger and going higher. We're going to change the max particles to 10 and the number of particles to 1. And you can see the different effect that that has on our particles. Let's leave that setting in place, max particles 10 and number of particles to 1 for a moment. And let's go ahead and change the light properties to emit light. Now you notice when we turn that on, it actually lights up the area. And if you watch the ground as the particles rise and fall, it actually changes the light pattern on not only the walls, but the ground itself. So let's modify this a bit and change the attenuation up to 80 and notice the change in brightness around the cafe. In this example, we're going to go ahead and set attenuation to 15 and we're going to change the process to by time. So I think yours by default was set to no change. We want to set ours to by time. And then we're just going to change these numbers to 1, 2, 3, and 4. The next change we'll make is to change the colors from white to the color of your choosing. I'm going to choose red and yellow, green and blue. And you'll notice as you do that, the particles actually emit to different colors instead of white. Now, based upon the time, they should shoot out at red, turn yellow, green, and blue at 4. Now, I don't think the particles are staying in the air long enough to actually hit number 4, so we don't see the blue color. What I could do is change this to 0.03, 0.06, 0.09, and 1.2. Now, I should see a blue color as a result of that. And I do, I see blue now. You'll notice the other effect that this has is it actually changes the colors on not only the walls but the ground and surrounding area. So if I change the attenuation up to 80, you'll notice that it actually has a bigger impact. The area surrounding the cafe is actually increased because the attenuation was increased. I'm going to change it back to 15. And you can play around with the different colors and the emit light options. Now for a completely different effect, I could change the max particles back to 500 and change the number of particles to 30, and you'll notice I get a completely different particle effect. Okay, so now time to add some fire. Let's go ahead and add some fire here in the back end of the cafe. And we'll go to the back corner, and in these two planter boxes, we'll go to particle number 2 again, and we will select flame spray wide or narrow, whichever one you would like. I'm going to choose wide, and I'm going to add it to the middle of each planter box. Once I have that done, I'll go ahead and open up the properties window, or the editor window again. And instead of trying to select the particle, I can go to the drop-down list and select flame wide emitter 2 or 3. I'm going to select 2 first, and I want these to shoot straight up instead of at an angle like they are, so I'm going to change the pitch to 290. And that's a little too far, so 280. And that's good enough for this example. I'm going to do the same with the other. And on the middle one, I'm going to change the strength up to 3000. Now, to actually increase the number of particles on this to make it look a little better, I'm going to increase the particles to 60. And the number of particles to 5. And I need a few more particles in there, so I'll change it to 10. I do hope that they have fire insurance at the cafe. That's a pretty neat effect. We'll go ahead and leave that, play around with that as you would like. Let's go ahead and move to the opposite corner here. And in these two planter boxes, again, we're going to go back to number 2. And we're going to add smoke to one of the planter boxes. And then let's add fire to the other one. Now, if I wanted to make that fire bigger, again, I'll select that emitter. And the first thing I want to do is change the position. I'll change it to 3. And you notice that actually increases or raises the height of the emitter. And I'll change the strength up to 5. And let's go out here over by the other buildings that we placed. And maybe in the middle of one of the buildings, let's place an actual fountain. And if it's too big, hold down the left mouse button to size it. And we'll just go ahead and we'll place it on the sidewalk right between two of the buildings. Okay, so now we're going to change the properties of this. Again, we go to the editor or the particle properties, and I want to change the strength to 12,000. Now you'll notice how high that actually shoots up, and that's what I want. I don't want that many particles, however, so I'm going to change the max particles down to 10 and number of particles to 1. I'm going to turn on emit light, set the attenuation to 15, by time for process. Here again, I'm going to do 1, 1.5, 3, and 4.5. And then I'm going to change the colors. So I'm going to start with a light blue, which changes into a yellow, and that changes into a red, which then changes into an orange. So now if I scroll out, what we'll notice is that on the ground, you can actually see those particle colors moving on the ground, kind of like a disco or spotlight. We need it a little bit brighter, so I'm going to change the attenuation to 20. I'm going to up the particles to 3 and 20. And that gives me a few more spotlight type effects here on the ground. Now that's a really neat effect in a big park. You could place 2 or 3 of these and cover the entire park and have lights that just move across the ground throughout your entire park. Okay, so let's work on the coaster and adding some water effects to it. To do that, we're going to have to open up the terrain editor. And we're going to select the hill. And I'm going to lower the size by holding down the control key. And then I'm going to hold down shift to actually create an indention where I want water. And for this particle effect, I'm going to go ahead and turn on the daytime. Now you'll notice that when I lowered the land, the supports didn't actually connect. To get those to connect, all I need to do is select the node and either move it left or right, or hold down shift and raise it up or down, and they automatically connect to the ground. So let's go ahead and turn on water. And using the Control-Alt tip from Troy, I'm going to go ahead and select some of these 3 nodes here. And I'm going to go back to Path Properties and add a fence to the side of the path so that people don't jump in the water. Okay, now to add the spray effect, we're going to go to, I believe it's particle number 2. Nope, it is 1. And we want dual water spray train triggered. And I'm going to make this just a little bit bigger than it already is and move it up to the land a little bit and then hold down the control key to rotate it. And it's okay if I place it under the water. I'm going to place 2 or 3 just along the track here. Again, if I wanted to, I could hold down the shift key and drag up and then left click to place it closer to the track. But I'm just going to go back here and select them and then hold down shift and drag them up. Now here's a little trick. I'm not going to hide them in the water. I'm just going to change the texture of these so that you can't see them. So with the purple bar selected, I'm going to open up the material editor and click on get from selected. And this will actually change it to spray emitter 2 material. I think yours may be set to a texture. Again, I was playing around with it prior to recording. Go ahead and change it to smoke, and you'll notice that it all but disappears. Now you can play around with the different textures to find out which one you want to use. I just use smoke here, and then I could actually lower it a bit and put it in the water and you would never see it. Again, with these coaster nodes, I could put them closer to the water as well. This isn't to be perfect, this is just to demonstrate some of the tools within Theme Park Studio. So now let's start our coaster and let's see what happens when it rolls over. Okay, let's turn Test Coaster off. And let's look at a few of the properties here on the spray emitters. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure that I have that spray emitter selected. It's kind of hard to see now that I've changed the texture. Again, if I went back to the editor or the properties window, I could always select it from the drop down list. Now, spray emitters have something called scale, and again, you can read about that in the documentation, but they have a force multiplier based upon how fast the coaster actually travels over it will control how high or low the spray particle actually emits. I assume you could also emit light from those. I've not played around with those, or have I played around with the distribution settings much. This is set to train proximity, so when the train comes within 15, I assume this is feet, the emitter will actually disperse. Remember that I placed a fountain here in between the buildings. I'm going to go ahead and place another fountain here underneath the coaster. And I'm going to actually place this one in the water. And then I'm going to change it to night and let's see what kind of effect that has when the train passes over. Now you can see the spotlight effect on the ground here. If I were to increase the number of particles or increase the brightness, of course the patterns would change. The other cool thing is you notice on the track, the lights actually impact the track as well. On a white track, you actually see the different colors here because the track is red. Not so much. Here comes our coaster. Pretty cool. Notice our fire burning in the background there. I'm surprised the cafe has not yet burned down. Okay, so one last particle we're going to go ahead and add would be the explosion particle, and let's add that just before the spray emitters. So again, this is going to be under particle number 2, and we'll select explosion. Now you notice that I don't have really any objects to place it to. I don't know if we can place it on the support. We cannot. So in this case, we would actually have to place a ground object to be able to use the explosion. Go to Custom Scenery, number 2, and I use these stucco wood supports. And I increase the size holding down the left mouse button, then I drag them up just under the coaster. Now again, this is a quick example. I'm not trying to hide them, just showing you some of the possibilities. So I'm going to go ahead and select explosion, and I'm going to attach them to each one of these stucco wood posts. And let's put our train in motion and see what happens when it comes through. Okay, here's the end result. I've changed the colors and some of the properties of the smoke effect, and I have kind of a pretty neat fiery type effect with the smoke heading into the tunnel. One other thing that I've done is under particle number one, there's a blank emitter down at the bottom, and I've added that underneath the tunnel. And I'm wondering if I can now place particle emitter smoke on top of the blank emitter. It looks like you can. And it actually added the smoke to all 3 blank particle emitters. So I may have just found a shortcut here to duplicate the smoke particle effect. I placed the blank emitter, then added the smoke effect onto the blank emitter. Let's see what happens when I change these properties. If it changes all at the same time, that would be a shortcut. And it looks like it is going to. Now that is pretty neat. Okay, so as you can see, particles are not only powerful, but they have a lot of properties that can be changed, and you can create some really neat effects. I look forward to seeing what kind of effects you guys create in your parks and on your rides, and I hope that this video has been helpful in explaining some of the particles and different effects, as well as the lighting. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the video, and I'll do my best to respond to those. This was video 3 in the Build With Me series. I'll see you next time.